Hello and welcome back to the Salesforce Health channel, and today we're going to discuss about the difference between process builder and workflows. I'm going to tell you that why you need to go for process builder instead of workflows, and when there is a need to go for a workflow instead of process builder. So let's begin. So process builder and workflows, both are the automation tools which executes whenever the record gets created or edited. But the difference is, workflow is an old school automation tool. Process builder gives you a user-friendly visual representation of the process as you build it. So let's talk about the first difference that we have between workflows and process builder. You can do more with process builder as compared to workflows. So in workflows, we have four types of actions. One, send an email. Second, field update. Third, task. And fourth is outbound message. Whereas with process builder, we have eight actions that are: create a record, update the records which are related to it, post something onto charter, launch a flow, launch a quick action, submit automatically for the approval, call an apex code, and the last one is invoke another process. So all of the administrators out there who were thinking that they really need to learn programming or learn how to code apex triggers to do different automations, you need to rethink that, or you really do not need to learn apex if you want to do automation, because process builder is there for you. You can do multiple things using it which you are not able to do using workflows. But there is still one thing that you'll not be able to do using a process builder, and that is you'll not be able to send an outbound message. For that, you'll have to go for the workflow rules, obviously. The second and the most important reason because of which you should go for process builder instead of workflow rules is that it allows you to control the order of different actions, that at which criteria which action will get executed, and after that this criteria should be evaluated. So you'll be able to control the evaluation criteria of the processes using process builder, which you are not able to do with workflows. Let me explain it to you. If you created four workflow rules on a single object, which one is going to execute first and which one is going to execute next? You cannot predict that. Nobody in this world can predict that. But in process builder, we can create actions or create a process in such a way that we can order all of the actions or all of the criterias in the order we want. And there is something that I want to tell you from the Salesforce side. Salesforce says that we are not anymore working or enhancing the features on workflows. Instead, we are working on process builder, but the support for the workflows will still be there in the organizations which have already implemented it, or basically in all the organizations of Salesforce. And that makes sense as well, because you can do so much more using process builder that you were not able to do using workflows. So use process builders. And even if you have created workflows earlier in your organization to do the automation, just migrate those workflows into processes. Yeah, you can do that. And in fact, if you have created some triggers as well, if you have created some apex triggers to do certain kind of automation, you can convert, you can think about it, that whether you can do that task using a process builder. If yes, then remove that particular trigger and create a process for it. Because as Salesforce says, always go for the declarative approach when it is possible using that. And only if you are not able to do something with a declarative approach, then only go for the coding part or the programmatic approach. And I want to make a note over here. Please do not use both of the things on a single object, workflows and process builders. Use only process builders if all the automation can be done using it. Use workflows only if you have already created workflows and the automations that you're doing are only possible using workflows. Do not implement both of them, because Salesforce cannot guarantee the order of execution of them, and that may create some problems for you. So make sure that whatever you're doing on that particular object, or whatever automation you're implementing on that particular object, implement it using a single tool. This is the best practice. And there's a question for you guys. If we cannot do a particular action, or if we are not able to do a particular automation using workflows as well as process builder, then what should we do? Go for apex triggers, because we all know that if the declarative approaches doesn't work, then we need to go for the programmatic approach. And in that case, using apex, you can do literally anything what you want. With apex, sky is the limit. So you can implement any kind of automation that you want. So for that, you need to learn apex triggers. And that's all about the differences between process builder and workflow. Now you can think on your own that whether you should go from process builder or workflows. or whether there's a need to convert or to migrate all of your workflows into processes. The next video that I'll be creating on my channel will be of Process Builder. I'm going to explain you that how to create processes in Process Builder, how to execute different actions or how to implement different actions into it, and how to basically use it. So stay tuned to the Salesforce Hulk channel, because it's the best channel which provides the real Salesforce content on YouTube. And make sure, if you haven't subscribed to the channel, click over here to hit the subscribe button to get weekly videos all related to Salesforce with the Salesforce Hulk. See you next week, and then bye bye, take care.